Hello everyone! Welcome to Tech to Tinker. My name is George, and in this video, we will talk about the relay module with ESP32 using MicroPython. A relay is an electrical switch that is controlled through the signal pin. It is commonly used to isolate or separate the external circuit with a higher voltage supply from the microcontroller circuit, which usually works with low voltage such as the ESP32, which works on 3.3 volts voltage level. A relay basically works like this. I have here a simulation using the Proteus. This is a relay. We have here a switch that we can switch on and switch off. Then when the relay, let me first click the run button here. So now the relay is connected to the normally closed lamp. This is the common pin. This is the normally closed pin, and this is the normally open. And as you can see, we have here a battery, and there are two lamps here. One is for the normally closed lamp. Another is for normally open lamp. Currently, it is connected with the normally closed lamp, as you can see, because this needle is connected to the normally closed pin. But when we close the switch, the needle of the relay changes from normally closed to normally open pin, consecutively turning on the normally open lamp. Let me open again the circuit and close again. Let's see. What I have here is a relay module included in GorillaCell ESP32 development kit. It has 3 pins for the control signal pin, which are G for the ground pin, V for the supply voltage, and S for the control signal pin. On the other side, it has normally open, common pin, and normally closed pin. Normally open pin is not connected to COM pin when the relay is not active. Hence, it is called normally open. So, as you can see here, the NO pin is not connected to the common pin, but it is connected to the normally closed pin. Activating the relay by providing a logic 1 on the signal pin, just like switching the switch like this, engages the common pin to the normally open pin. Consecutively, this engages from the normally closed pin because it only toggles between normally open and normally closed pin. It happens because when the switch is closed like this, or when the signal pin is applied, the electromagnet here, this is electromagnet symbol, will activate the magnet and attracts the needle to the normally open and disengages from the normally closed pin. In order to follow this lesson, you will need an ESP32 development board, a GorillaCell ESP32 shield, a 3-pin, female-to-female DuPont jumper wires, and of course, the relay module itself. In using the GorillaCell development kits, the following should be observed. When attaching the DuPont wires to the modules, the color coding should be followed. That is black for the ground, red for the VCC, and yellow for the signal pin. While when attaching the other side of the DuPont wires to the ESP32 shield, match the colors of the wires to the colors of the pin headers, such that black is to black, red is to red, and yellow and the following colors to the yellow pin headers. For this lesson, I choose GPIO23 to serve as the control signal pin for the relay module. Now for the software part, let's begin with the basics. I prepared here a simple source code to demonstrate how to control a relay. It begins by importing the pin class from the machine module and created a pin object named relay, which is connected on GPIO23 with the pin direction set as an output. Now, we can activate the relay by giving it a value of 1. Like this one. Relay that value of 1. Currently, just like this, by providing a value of logic 1, the relay will engage the common terminal to the normally open pin, such as like this one. But first, let me click run button and let me paste again the source code. Currently, the LED is off. But when I hit enter, sending a value to the GPIO23 of logic 1, which will turn on the relay, or giving it a value of 0 turns off the relay. Currently, the LED is off. Giving it a value of 1 will turn on the LED, which indicates that the relay is activated. Now on. Give it a value of 0, will turn it off. Now for the application, I have prepared here a simple setup. Basically, I have here a 12 volts battery and a motor. 12 volts motor. Let me attach it to the relay and let's observe how we can use the relay on controlling this motor. So I will attach the one terminal to the normally open pin while the other terminal to the common pin, so that when the relay is activated by sending a relay that value of 1 will turn on this motor, because the battery will flow from the normally open pin to the common pin going to the DC motor. Let us see. Let's send a value of 1. It turns on the motor. Give it a value of 0, turns off the motor. Easy, right? Please be careful when working with AC voltages because it is lethal. You may want to ask help when following this unless you know what you are doing. But I am working with DC 12 volts, so it's very safe. But it's still be very careful because when you connect the ground and the positive voltage, you might produce a magic smoke or you can cause a fire. Let's modify the source code. Let's say, let me save it. Save as. Let's call it relay example number 2. And let's use the switch to turn on or turn off this DC motor. I will just delete this one. Let's create a variable is active, set to false, and let's create a while loop, while true. Let's create another pin object to read the button. Let's call it bot is equal to pin, or better call it switch is equal to pin. This is connected on pin 0 in that in, and it is logic low. So if switch that value equal to 0, then is active is equal to not is active. We just toggle it. Then we check here if is active, or better, we just directly put it as a relay that value is active. So I think this will work. Let me save it and let me click the stop button. Terminate the example number one and let's try this example number two. Now, currently, the switch is off because the isActive variable is currently false. But when I press the boot button, it toggles the isActive switch. If I press it again, it turns off the motor or the relay. Again, let's turn it off. Okay, so that's pretty much it. I hope you learned something from this. As always, the source code that is in here, including other information, can be found in the companion blog post for this video at techtothinker.blogspot.com. Links in the video description. If you have any question, please write your message in the comment box provided. And if you enjoyed this video, please do like and share so that it can reach more people who might benefit from this. Please don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell because I will be uploading more videos like this in the future. Thank you and see you next time. God bless.